What's up, guys? Jake here, and I'm with Rusty. And we are in, or we're on, Treasure Island. Yes, there is a place called Treasure Island. It is an island between San Francisco, which is right behind me, and Oakland. As you're going across the Bay Bridge, you have an option to get off on Treasure Island, which I did, and it has this picturesque view of San Francisco. It's quite awesome. This camera doesn't do it justice, but it's quite beautiful. There's the Bay Bridge in the background. Back out that way, you can't see it because of the glare from the sun. You got Alcatraz Island. Maybe you can kind of see it. Yes. Anyway, the wind is a whipping, and it is, no joke, 62 degrees as I am speaking to you. In July, the dead of summer, 62 degrees. Now, here's the beautiful thing about van life, my life, and living in California. People can talk shit about California, but I left the Sacramento area where it was 104 degrees. Over 100. It was 104. Came here where it is now 62 degrees. Super windy. I'm wearing a windbreaker, pants, socks. When I left Sacramento, I was miserable. I was sweating my balls off. And 2 hours later, a 2 hour car ride, and suddenly I jumped out of the van and I was like, oh shit. And I needed to grab a windbreaker, socks, and pants. So that is a 40 degree swing from 62 degrees. From 104 to 62 degrees. That's a 40 degree swing. So I'm going to head over to the beach. I usually go to Santa Cruz, but today I'm gonna mix it up. I'm gonna go over to Pacifica and then over to Half Moon Bay. Just haven't been to Treasure Island in quite a while. If you ever get a chance to check this place out, it's quite a funky little island. And the tourists have not mobbed this place yet, so you can still find parking, take a beautiful walk, and get some really awesome pictures over here. And so I recommend, if you ever visit the Oakland, San Francisco area, that you check out Treasure Island. Asian sheeple alert! Asian sheeple alert! These are the finer times of van life. I've been meaning to do this. I don't usually cook in the van, so I've been meaning to find a nice beach location where I can open the doors, set up my kitchen, cook a nice little meal, sit by the ocean and enjoy it, and just indulge in the finer times of van life. This is really what it's all about. Cooking your breakfast with a pristine view of the ocean. 63 degrees in the middle of summer. I drove from a place where it's going to be 109 degrees in Sacramento. I drove here where it is 63 degrees. Got my kitchen set up. My lovely cute dog here who's waiting for me to cook. And we are about to enjoy one of the finest breakfasts
you could possibly enjoy with the finest views that you could possibly enjoy with the finest dog in the world. Life doesn't get any better than this, except if it does. All right, starting with some diced ham and some butter. We're gonna do a very basic ham, egg, and cheese scramble. Very basic. Just gonna saute up some of this ham in the butter, and then I'm gonna throw in some eggs and cheese, scramble it up. Very basic, but it's very tasty, very easy. And yeah, smelling good. All right, very basic egg, cheese, ham scramble. Rusty patiently waiting for some. And there we go. I just cooked a meal with a view of the beach and about to grub out now. Yeah. All right, so you guys saw me eat my oceanside meal. Now I got dirty dishes. So what I do is I load them up in a plastic bag. So I got my dirty dishes here. And this sink is used for cleaning out fish guts. So it's perfect for me to do some dishes while I enjoy the ocean. So I packed up this bag, got some lemon juice. You guys are wondering why I have some lemon juice. It's because I also packed myself some beers. I got some beers in here, and I like to add a little bit of lemon juice to my beer. So, while I do dishes next to the ocean, I'm gonna also enjoy a cheap beer. And of course, I doctor up my cheap beer with the lemon juice. Yeah. All right. See? And I can enjoy a beer with the ocean, clean my dirty dishes, put them back in the backpack, and then, check it out, I ride my electric scooter all the way back down to my van over there. Way, way over there at the end of that parking lot. See? So it's like, I make my chores, such as doing dishes, into a lovely, breathtaking event. Oh, gotta love it. Again, the finer times of van life, doing your dishes next to the ocean. So damn near all of these fishermen are Vietnamese, and damn near all these Vietnamese fishermen are wearing muzzles while they're out fishing on the pier. Just another example of the fact that Asians are some of the most compliant cuck slaves in the world. What kind is that?
Kingfish.
Kingfish. Wow, pretty small for something called a kingfish.
Very big.
That is the biggest. It's a huge size.
Then again, I see people on this pier who keep like 2-inch fish and stuff. So you know. Okay. I guess on this pier that's a Goliath. Mammoth.
There we go.
No, wait, I gotta take a picture.
What? You can pan fry it. Pretty good.
Pan fry it?
Yeah.
That'd be really fun. Just take this kite thing out for a ride over the ocean like that. How awesome is that? Just flying like a bird, man. Asian sheeple alert! Asian sheeple alert! If you enjoyed this video, please do me a big favor and hit that like button. Also, make sure you have the bell turned on so that you get notified every time I make a new video. And if you have time, share this video with a friend or a family member. I'll see you next time. Peace.